everybody! Welcome back to Northernlion Plays the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Still pretty freaking jazzed to be playing Rebirth. We're gonna play as a different character this time. We played as Lazarus last time. I guess we're gonna play... I mean, we could play as Cain. Or Maggie. Fan favorites. But, why don't we go with Azazel? He's new. I knew I would never figure out how to pronounce this, but I said I would. So we start exclusively with black hearts and, like, a... Whoa! A really, really short distance. It's a weird layout for an item room here. A really, really short distance brimstone. But it charges really quickly. This is gonna be interesting. I have no idea how this is gonna work out. Inevitably, some people are gonna be mad that there's a character that starts with brimstone. Now, I didn't know this until now. So I take no credit for that. We also got Speedball, which, you know, you're at this point probably familiar with Speedball if you played the original game. Speedball gives you a shot speed upgrade, which probably doesn't matter for Brimstone, and a speed upgrade. You know, it's not my favorite item in the game. It's going to take us 233,000 years to actually destroy all this poop. That's okay, though, because we got nothing but time. If we get at least one more penny out of it, I will be so happy. So, are there just no tinted rocks in the... Oh my god. I thought that was quad shot for a second, and I got super excited. Are there just no tinted rocks in Rebirth? It would be a shame to lose them, I guess. Maybe I just haven't seen one yet, or maybe they've taken on a different form. So we have a pill. Oh my god, do we really have to fight Dingle every run? That whistle tone is super cute. Ooh, oh my god, I'm mad because I'm bad. He's so fast! I'm glad we got Speedball, because, you know... Oh my god! He's crazy, he's too strong! I'm not sure if I'm liking this Azazel guy as much as, maybe I'd just like to have your, you know, your standard kind of Isaac stuff. Oh, he takes a second and he's, he gets tired. I may actually die here right off the bat. I can't believe we lived. What is that? The nail? Screw. Tears plus shot speed up. That doesn't seem that useful for us in our situation. Our pill? I found pills. Okay. And then a bunch of fire that makes me angry. We also start with the ability to fly. I suppose I should shoot the fire. Probably gonna get hit in the process, though. Not if I go behind, I guess. See if maybe we can get some extra HP, because I'm pretty sure if I run out, I'm just done. I'll take the Fool card with me, but yeah, like, I'm pretty sure once I run out of HP, I'm just out of HP, so... I don't know how I feel about this character thus far, but I would say that, you know, step one is not necessarily going fantastically for us. Took 4 damage on the first floor, all against the boss. I really think Dingle... I mean, it's hard to say, because it might just be because I'm so familiar with, like, the standard vanilla bosses. But man, Dingle seems, like, so hard. I wonder if he'll still be there. No, the flies still disappear. Okie dokie. Free money. We're doing a lot of damage, and I like that, and I would love to see some sweet synergies. Oh, that's so... Oh, I can't pick it up, yeah. It was flashing, so I was wondering what's up. I would love to see some sweet synergies with this, but as of right now, I'm not necessarily, you know, thinking Azazel's gonna be one of my favorite characters here. Probably a really stupid idea for me to hit that troll bomb. So I'm gonna do it again. There is a key there, so at least we will be able to go to our item room. Possibly our shop if we get enough money. I'll tell you what, I'm hanging out behind these rocks. That makes my life a little bit easier. What an intense run so far. Yeah, okay. Really smart idea there. I'm dead. I became a ghost. Let's restart. I'm gonna play as the same character. That was a death that I'm not super thrilled about. Oh! Careful. But these deaths are gonna happen, man. I can't come into this with the same standards I had for Vanilla Isaac, where if I died, I would just, like, give up. Alright, so that's, Ohmwrecker's hat. Libra, you feel balanced. I wonder what that does. It would be sweet if it put all our stats like at the same level or something like that, but I have no idea. And I'm enjoying not knowing. It's new, so I'm happy with it. Let's hopefully not fight Dingle on this run. I was gonna say, you're telling me I can't kill these guys in one hit? That's the bonus of this run. I have damage. That's the one thing I should be able to hang my hat on here. Hmm. A champion took way more hits than I expected. So I would like to get some HP. The way I imagine it works, it seems like HP is like way harder, pardon me, way harder to come by in Rebirth. Maybe just because, oh, there's a tinted rock. That's so subtle compared to the normal tinted rocks. Holy crap, I'm gonna miss so many of those. Oh my god, I wonder how many I've missed thus far. That is crazy subtle. I think that's better. Oh, there's another one down here. Oh, you know what it did? It gave me, it balanced my consumables. You see, like, I think I had 666 there. What's up with these flies? Oh, geez. So that's stupid of me. It didn't bring all my stats to the same level. I think it brought all my consumables up to the highest level. Or maybe just up to the level of our one individual one. Anyway, it's all good. There's another tinted rock down here. Oh, the tinted rocks are crazy. And I was crazy for not seeing them before. Oh, thank God we can fly. Okay, let's fight our boss. Not Dingle. Anybody but Dingle. Larry Jr. Oh, Brimstone. That's a weird Larry Jr. there, dog. But Brimstone versus Larry Jr. is pretty solid. Oh, that's beautiful. All right, I don't know if that was a champion Larry Jr. or if that was some kind of different enemy altogether. That didn't work out the way I thought it was. I actually created another Larry Jr. from nothing. I am become death, destroyer of my own morale. Thankfully, we found so many tinted rocks. Come on, Larry J. There we go. And that's another new item. Safety pin. Evil plus range plus shot speed up. I don't know if our Brimstone actually got, like, a bigger range there. I haven't been to all our rooms, so we're gonna do a little bit more exploration here. We're definitely in a much more survivable situation as Azazel. I look like somebody took a hatchet to one side of my face right now, chopped off, like, one of my horns. Luckily, I'm still aerodynamic. Ooh, watch out for that. Alright, I'm digging it. New items. Dare we look for a secret room on the first floor? See if they changed it so that you can actually find one on the first floor without just being super lucky. Okay. The more things change, the more they stay the same. I'm not going to go to our shop. Because I don't have enough money to get anything. Unless there's like a penny in the fire in there, but I doubt it. Decent first floor, though. I'm happy with it. Let's head down to the... I should have shot more of the poop, but whatever. Down to the next floor. You know what? I'm going to be skipping the vignettes just because I think they are the same ones we've seen before. So let's just get a move on here. So we got a big room. I'm actually not sure how I feel about big rooms when I have such limited range. And the range upgrade didn't really seem to help me that much. There's another tinted rock there. That effect is going to cause so much trouble for me. People are going to be so angry because I'm going to miss so many. Oh, that's a lot of money for us on this early floor. $3 bill. This should be really cool to see if it actually works. If it synergizes in some weird way with our Brimstone shots. We will go to the curse room. Do I just have to hurt myself to get that then? Or do bombs put them out or something? Bombs put out blue fire. Now we know. Oh, yes! So happy to have 9 lives. Took some dumb damage there. That actually had the rare distinction of giving me some HP. So if you thought, you know, you had it weird with 9 lives before, certainly seems a lot more difficult now. Oh, you know what? I have, like, flaming tears on this room. Did you see that? Like, some of these enemies were on fire. I'm so happy Rebirth is out so I can, like, get that sense of discovery back about, like, you know, just looking at clues in the environment, being like a roguelike detective, which is the title of the show that I pitched to the CBC, but those hosers told me to, you know, take off. Anyway, it's enough Canadiana for one day. So it doesn't have the kind of... Oh, that was bad. It doesn't seem yet to have the kind of synergy I was hoping for. I was hoping for, like, a, you know, sometimes we would get triple shot and have triple Brimstone or something like that, but it seems like, seems like maybe, well, maybe triple shot isn't a part of $3 bill in Rebirth. I don't know. We'll see. I think this is the first time that we fought Monstro in Rebirth, so I'm excited about that. I know I've said this a lot, but I really love that effect when the monsters land. Can't really see what our tier effect is. I would love to see Mom's contact with this, just from a damage perspective. That would be sweet. But I'm mostly excited to maybe become Guppy, and this could be the first time I ever have a Guppy Brimstone run and people don't get pissed off about it. That would be a welcome change of pace. If there still is a Guppy transformation, who knows, right? Oh, that's a new item. It's like half of a picture. Torn photo, tears plus shot speed up. Well, I don't really want that much in our situation. You know what? I wonder if I'll lose all my hearts by taking Whore of Babylon. I didn't. I lost my red heart, which is expected, but I also got Whore of Babylon, which has improved like all of my other stats. I like being able to see the whole map here, too. All right. So I'm content with this thus far. Let's go to our shop. We can find our secret room if we have to. 1+1 = exclamation mark. I don't know what that is. Humbling bundle. 1+1 free forever. So it's the humble bundle. I guess that all consumables that drop now will be two of them. Which we had that same effect, I think, earlier. Oh, we can totally go to our boss trap room. Yeah, okay, maybe all keys and all bombs. No, there were two pennies there, too. Oh, sweet. All right, yeah, we totally have enough keys to open that. Watch out for that, though. Tons of money, though, and we do pick up a another two keys just from opening that chest. That seems like a really good item, especially to get on the cheap. Like, how quickly would it pay for itself if it gives you double every coin drop for the rest of the game? Seems pretty good. Should be Larry Jr. next. Yeah. Several Larry Jr.'s. Poor Babylon working out pretty nicely for us. I think I need to recalibrate a little bit. I mean, it's too early to say this definitively. Do we have more rooms? No, that's all of them. We'll look for our secret room, though. Maybe we won't. We don't have many bombs. We totally will, though. There we go. Lucky us. And we get four bombs out of it. This is a weird room. Oh, there we go. That'd be like number one there or something like that. I think I need to recalibrate because it really seems right now like there are a lot less HP drops in Rebirth than there are in Vanilla Isaac. So, I think my strategy of trading all of my red hearts away maybe doesn't necessarily end up being the smartest strategy anymore. We'll see though. Caves Part 1. Oh, what's this? Probably homing tears? Just the color effects from $3 Bill are so sweet now, though, that they actually work with Brimstone. I swear this song's got, like, that Hotline Miami kind of, like, lazy electric guitar thing going on. Oh my god. This room had 8 cents in it, thanks to Humble Bundle. That item at half price is, like, the most obvious pickup of all time. I think. And, of course, I imagine I'll probably end up looking back on these early Rebirth episodes in, like, a couple of months and being like, wow, you know nothing, Northernlion. We'll see, though. I hope my genuine enthusiasm is carrying over here, because I am, like, well and truly having some of the most fun I've ever had on YouTube just by playing this. I've been waiting for this game for so, so long. That, look at this money. It's ridiculous. If we didn't have Kane before, we would definitely have him by the end of this run. We already have 50 cents. And now we're... Oh, it doesn't give us double nickels, though. Okay. Because that would be crazy. We did gain some, like... Well, we spent 7 cents when we had 12, so we gained 58 cents in one floor. That's kind of ridiculous. I'm happy. Maybe some of this stuff will be patched out eventually, but for now, I'm a big fan of Humbling Bundle. Humble Bundle, whatever it was called. I know what the Humble Bundle is, by the way. I just thought it had a different name in this one. That's it. More keys. So we'll definitely visit our shop when we find it. We'll definitely visit our item. Oh, we'll definitely open that. Oh my god. We're gonna get to 99 cents so quickly. Oh, look at this, it's crazy. And how good would that be? Imagine this item, and we might run into this situation. I'll take Red Patch. It's okay, Trinket. And we'll have to take Poison Touch, so I'll take it. Or Virus, I should say. It's our chance to finally start getting the names right. Imagine that, though, the Humble Bundle, when you play Blood Banks. That seems like, not only are you getting double HP, so you can play them probably twice as much, but you're getting double the money from each one as well. So if you ever needed money, but I guess you wouldn't if you already had the item, because it gives you seemingly more money than you could ever know what to do with. Remote Detonator. I'm gonna buy the Spirit Heart. I'm gonna buy a remote detonator just because we don't have anything better to do and it gives us 5 bombs. And I'm gonna give like as much money as I can to the donation machine before it breaks. Yeah, because like we're gonna get so much money that it doesn't really matter. Sure, let's fight our boss right away. I don't mind. Oh, we're going up against the Fallen! This is our first time for this one. So I'm gonna try to use remote detonator effectively. Who knows how many opportunities we'll have to do that before we get, like, the D6 and end up having to use that on every run. Alright, there's one dead. Remote detonator, if you're not familiar, basically you get 5 bombs as a bonus, but it also allows you, oh, Sister Maggie, thank God. But it also allows you to place, or to blow up the bombs when you want to. So you just press space and explode them. 3 spirit hearts for Ghost Baby. Like, I think that's pretty bad, so I'm not even gonna take that. We've had Ghost Baby before, so it's not like we'd even be getting a bonus in terms of, like, items or anything like that. That's not our secret room. And we'll put this here and blow it up. That's not our secret room. Luckily, we have a ton of opportunities here. A ton of bombs. There's our secret room. And we get another 4 bombs. All right, that's fine. I imagine this is kind of the room that when you go into it and you waste bombs, you're like, oh, that's not worth it. Because normally you'd only get 1 bomb out of it. A little disappointed we got Sister Maggie as our item there, but whatever. It happens. Yeah, see, we only get a single nickel. Little disappointing, but let's be honest, our financial situation is pretty okay. This is our last room. And we'll leave, and I'm feeling like, you know, I want to beat Mom's Heart. That's my obvious goal for this episode, beat it for the first time, but to beat it with Azazel. Azazel. Dazzle. It would be, it's cooler with the Dota references there, puppy. I'll be excited. Why did the boss room, like, door glows red? That's cool. I don't think I've seen that before. Trapdoor stays closed as well. Smart idea in case you need to pick up, like, items or consumables on top of it. Alright, Caves Part 2. Let's do this. We found an arcade right off the bat, so this is what I was excited about. But when we play the Blood Bank, I think we don't have any red hearts, so we'll just end up, like, losing all of our... Oh, we, like, confusing tiers or something as $3 bill, I think. We'll end up losing a lot as a result of that. Like, we'll lose all of our HP capacity. What is this room? Oh my god. So this room, it has a 5 on it. Like the dice face of a 5. I wonder if you like... Woo! Alright, I have no idea what happened there. I was kind of speechless, but here we are. I hope I didn't lose out on a floor. I wonder if that, if you stand on that long enough, like it allows you to reroll the whole floor or something. It was very, very unusual. But whatever. we'll solve that mystery a little further into our Isaac career, I guess. Oh, the cash is gonna be enormous. I hope the donation machine isn't broken for the whole run. I hope we can give more money to it now, because this is really the best opportunity we've ever had to do so. We can fly, so this doesn't really worry me. Bats are pretty cute, I gotta say. And as much as I've been complaining about not having HP... Oh yeah, flame damage, fire damage. I would love to keep having no HP, because it's giving us such a damage bonus thanks to... thanks to Whore of Babylon. Oh, really, really poor damage there. That's okay. Speed up. I could use that. I'm already pretty fast, but I could use that. For people wondering what this Fool card is, by the way, or wondering if I know that I have it, at least. I know that I have it. It teleports you from whatever room you're standing in to the spawn of the entire floor. So the first room that you start in. The reason I'm not using it is because typically you use it, at least if you're not trying to get yourself out of a terrible pinch, you use it to, oh, there's a shop right there. To give yourself a better chance of getting a deal with the devil after the mom fight. Normally you get trapped in the mom fight. R. Kelly style. Alright, we're gonna check out our shop. Nun's Habit, absolutely. We'll buy a spirit heart as well. It does look like the donation machine is just straight up broken. So that makes sense again, so that you can't just have one really good run like we're having right now and then just unlock every item in the game. That seems a little cheesy, so I understand it. Confusing tiers seem pretty useful, actually. I could totally see the value in those. Now, Caves Part 2, I got confused by that, like, weird floor reroll, which is maybe what that room is. Yeah, that's still pretty early in the game. So, although I'm happy with our position, I'm also a little bit scared for the future. This game feels so much smoother than Vanilla Isaac. Like, I think it'll be hard to go back, just even for, like, casual play. The frame rate is so nice. Alright, we got an Eternal Heart. I don't know how that's gonna work with our current setup, but... that extend our range at all? Maybe a little bit? It's hard to tell. I don't think it did, though. That's a great sound. So again, I know I said I didn't want to pick up any HP, but again, we're playing not strategically as much as we're playing just to figure out what's going on in the game, so I figured why not check out an Eternal Heart? We haven't had one in quite some time. Well, we haven't had one in Rebirth at all, I think. I expect that it'll give us one Red Heart container. That's, we've had that. That's Unicorn, Stub, right? Unicorn Stump? Yeah. That would be useful for things like Blood Banks, but I kind of feel like Remote Detonator is cooler. Sorry, so Unicorn Stump, I'm sorry, but you have become the first item that's been voted off the Isaac Island. You've become the first item that I don't really want to see anymore. Even Lemon Mishap, I remember saying. I think Lemon Mishap might even be better than Unicorn Stump. It's not bad, and I could see it being used situationally, but... well, it is bad, because you would never want to carry it over many other spacebar items. But situationally, if you had to use it, you could find a use for it. Oh, so we have a boss trap room, which we still should be able to access. And now if we've committed, basically, to getting more HP, I guess I'll happily pick up lunch or breakfast or something in there, if that's what it is. Room pays for itself in terms of its keys here. Lots of consumables. Happy to see that. Oh, I didn't mean to waste a key there, but it's a relatively minor deal, I guess. That's such a good item. Like, the Humble Bundle item just seems so overpowered. So, there's one thing I'm not too fond of. Although it's a balance change that makes the game a little tougher, which might be good. Boss trap rooms that only have a regular chest on them. That kind of sucks. But I wonder if, you know, Ed, Tyrone, and Spider watched a lot of Isaac videos, not from me necessarily, but from everybody that plays Isaac, and we're like, boss trap rooms are like a little too easily exploitable. Just tilt them back in the game's favor a little bit. This room's a big challenge, and we're not really gaining that much value out of it at all. So I'm a little scared about it. But Peep's not so difficult either. We got enough bombs, and we'll probably be able to use bombs, like, really, really aggressively if we so choose. So that's why I'm kind of using them a little bit more often. Especially combined with Remote Detonator, it's fun. Plus, maybe we'll end up in a situation where we fight a boss and we can just put, like, 30 bombs down on the ground and explode them all at the same time. Butt Penny. Butt Penny is my current item. Wealth of Gas. So I guess when you pick up a penny, maybe it'll give you a chance to... forgot that I had to use Remote Detonator. When you pick up a penny, it'll give you a chance to fart? That's what Eminem talked about, right? You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. I didn't expect that to work anyway, just because of where I placed the bomb, but... surely there has to be a secret room somewhere around here. Alright, well... I love you too, game. We're gonna head down to the next floor. It should be Depths Part 1. Is the Depths Part 1, and there's our one Red Heart, so that's gonna cause us a damage penalty. Oh, is that Common Cold? No, Bob's Brain. Explosive Thoughts. Okay, that actually seems really, dare I say, bad. But if it's only used once per room, it's a little easier to manage. Oh, no, it's several times per room. It's like a free Bob's Rotten Head. It scares the crap out of me, though. It only explodes when it actually hits an enemy. Yeah, this is bad for business, man, because I'm going to explode so many enemies so close to me that it does indeed seem to be what Butt Penny does, by the way. Okay, just cool it on the bomb thing there. I think it has to hit an enemy to explode. That's the way it looks, at least. Okie dokie. It seems like a very interesting item that I might actually hate. There we go, at least we got some value out of it there. So with this guy, I'm like, hey, you know, I'm just gonna stay the hell away from you. Because mostly, I just don't want you to get close, yeah. Turns out, that might have been a smart idea. Hey, throw the, yeah, there we go. Bob's Thoughts seems very interesting, but like Ipecac, kind of likely to backfire on you. There we go. We're all right. There's a curse room. We have enough spirit arts to feel pretty good about going through with the curse room, I'd say. Fair enough. Easy room. Lover's card. Not very good. Two black hearts. Hey, that's fine. You know. That's basically raw HP for us. There's like a piece of paper on the ground here. I don't think we can do anything with it, but... Everything in Rebirth has got me, you know, tripping up. When I see pieces of paper on the ground, I'm like, well, maybe that's some kind of secret that I'm not aware of. It's probably just nothing, though. Oh. What the? Oh, that was Bob's... Ugh, that's an item that I could definitely see people being of two minds about. It's a little... I'm not trying to make, you know, oh, I'm in such a poor place here. I'm not trying to be like that at all. But I think it's a little worse for me because the miniature brimstone here... I wonder how you... Oh, let's just stay away from them. Makes sense given the purple color. But anyway, I think it's a little worse for me because I have to be super close to the enemy with this, like, weird truncated brimstone. That's fine. Oh, I thought I hurt myself there, and I pretty much did. Yeah, I'm not loving this Bob's thoughts item, or explosive thoughts, Bob's brains. Forever alone, we got an attack fly, an old favorite from Vanilla Isaac that I'm happy to see again. Whoa, okay. Yeah, those shots, first off, I love that sound effect, like Super Mario World, like boo sound. But I'm a little annoyed by the fact that they seem very strong. My HP is in a bad place, but hey, I do have 9 lives, right? This is like a spooky variant on this floor, too. I didn't even notice until now because I was so wrapped up in my own stuff. Oh, we're fighting greed for the first time. But, yeah, this is definitely like a spookier variety. Wow, that was the super easy fight. We'll be at like 99 cents. Oh, the poop clouds. All right. Yeah, this is like some kind of ghost house variety or something like that. Very interesting. Dare I say. We've been to our item room? Yeah, we did skip a little bit of this floor, but that's okay. We'll fight Monstro 2, then we'll come back. Why dodge right into it? Now, Monstro 2 is no longer the pushover that he was. But we have fought him before. He wasn't so bad. That poison damage seems helpful. Attack Fly's doing what Attack Fly does. Alright, we seem pretty powerful. I mean, I guess that's the thing. You kind of start powerful as this character. I would love to have a one-heart deal with the devil for, like, a guppy item. No, oh, there is a deal with the devil? Okay. Our range upgrades are just making me long for rerolls, because I don't think they do anything for us here. So we got 3 flies. Dare I trade 1 heart for this weird baby? Rotten baby. Infested friend. Is it another, like, explosive shot or something? I have no idea. But I figured we'd take it because it's new. 23 bombs. Sure, I'll try here. I don't know if this was a harder variant on the floor, but it was tricky. I should be looking out for tinted rocks, too. They're so much more difficult to spot than they used to be. That's just a slot machine. I mean, you know what? I'll play it until we get down to like 90 cents. Which will never happen because we get double money. That pill could be good. I'll play it for a while, because I stand to gain. That pretty fly is nice. Yeah, I really stand to gain from it, so... 90 cents seems fair, even if it takes us a while to get there. Yeah. If you win, like, two times in a row, then you're basically just never going to stop. Bombs are key. It's not such a bad deal. Lemon party. Okay, we're learning about the pills in our rotation. That's important. And we got 2 more keys. We have golden keys on this floor, but still. Alright, 2 extra bombs. And I think the Fool card is what we want, not the Lover's card. We don't have any red hearts anyway. Let's do some exploration up here. I did go to our mob trap room. Yeah, I did. Okay. Like, this run's definitely winnable. What is up with these ghosts? Yeah, I think this run's definitely winnable. I don't know how much HP we respawn with because of 9 lives, but... I'm excited to see where it takes us. I think we could conceivably beat Mom's heart, but it would be nice to get a couple more, like, insurance items along the way as well. Alright, fair. Oh, there's still a deal with the devil, but we don't really want what it's got on for sale, so... Let's just try not to get ourselves killed by using Bob's brain in the wrong fashion. So it's Depths Part 2. We do have an arcade. I am going to go to the curse room. Two black hearts? I think that's pretty good, honestly. I'm happy with those. That room is meaningless to us. Oh, these MFers. Well, we got a ton of bombs. That's new Loki. We kind of pooped on him right off the bat, which is excellent. I don't like bomb flies with our build, though. I have no idea, by the way, what Rotten Baby actually does. But we have it, so that's cool. I love the poison effect, how they kind of like bubble now, too. That didn't hit him? What's my radius on these bombs? Oh, I think I just saw Rotten Baby take like a shot. It opens its mouth or something. Words don't just come out. Everybody's choking now. Yeah, no, I remember. Whoa. What the? Bomb? Yeah, okay. Use a bomb to open a chest. Very interesting. Emperor card, pretty useful. We'll take that with us, if I remember, once we leave this floor and head down to the womb. Oh, that was Bob's brain. I think we had charm shots on that room, which is another good one. You guys scare me a little bit. Did we kill it by getting it to, come on. Oh, could have so easily killed it there. Don't take damage, thank you. Don't charge your shot. That's the problem. I gotta be, like, so wary of when I'm charging my shot. I think Bob's brain just saved us a lot of heartache there. Map, great item. Don't really see the need to buy a bomb. Oh, come on. These enemies are the flippin' worst. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Oh, okay, I got blown into, like, the second secret room here. Well, you know what? I'm actually gonna spend a lot of time on this because I'm a little wary. We can use the stars card. Oh, is that cancer? Yeah, that's a good item. Charges our brimstone shot way faster. Oh, that's our fortune. I really want to get some spirit hearts here, so I'm gonna play the crap out of it. That's Liberty Cap. We might as well pick it up just so we have a record of having picked it up, I guess. Stars card we can use, like I said, instead of, oh, crystal ball, so good. Let's use it. Thank you for the spirit heart. Sorry, remote detonator, you've been great, but, we're gonna say see you later. Oh, I didn't actually finish you guys off. Yep, that could have easily hurt me. Might have been smart just to take remote detonator for this room. Where you at? There we go. All dead? Not all dead. All dead, thank God. They were annoying. High Priestess. High Priestess is pretty good. We can take that once we leave, but I think I'd rather take the Emperor card just to give me the best chance of beating Mom's heart. Shoot her! Okay, that was good. Very easy. On rooms where we're really, like, cooking here, we're firing on all cylinders. I don't know what's up with those heads. I think they might only die once you kill all the other enemies. Yeah, that's how it appears to be. Oh, Bob's brain. Come on, man. They're killing me here. Death. Good enough card to use. Not there. We're on our boss fight already. Did we go to our item room? I don't think so. So I guess we'll fight our boss, then Star's card out. Okay, this... I'm officially putting explosive thoughts into the category of items that I just don't want to F with. Oh, that was bad. There may well be situations where it's fantastic. But I'd kind of just prefer to not have to deal with it, I think. My brimstone shot charges... Oh my god, it hurt me again. My brimstone shot charges so quickly, by the way. Like, it actually... I just have to tap it. We very nearly died there. But we did pick up some HP. I guess we have an HP... Oh, I was gonna say, I guess we have an HP debt, but no. We got one of all kind now. We'll stars card out. There's Rainbow Baby. If only it could somehow cancel out. Oh, Guppy's Paw. Ooh. I was gonna say, we're probably gonna get shot there. You know what? Let's give ourselves Whore of Babylon back by trading that HP away. I so love that you don't Zelda the item over your head anymore. And yes. What was I going to say? That was actually a rare good use of what we had going on there. We'll go into our arcade just in the hopes that we can earn something from gambling here, I guess. But, oh, crystal ball's ready too. Thank you. We're one item away from becoming Guppy, the first Guppy transformation I'll have seen in Rebirth. So I'm excited about that. More spirit hearts is always a good thing. And really, you know, this is no holds barred, man. I'm trying to win, so I don't really mind if we end up spending 10 minutes here gambling. Plus, we get like the dollar, which would be a new item for us. Come on. No? Okay. Like, here's how long it takes to charge Brimstone with the Cancer Trinket. Not Brimstone, but like whatever our Brimstone is. That's how quickly we can fire. I should really get out of my old habits and start using it more frequently. Can you just stand next to it and like consistently? Oh, you can play it a lot faster. No question about that. Yeah, that's better. Can't believe it took me so long to notice. You can still win like this, right? You're not just throwing your money away? Yeah, you can still win. Keep it up, keep it up. It's much better than doing things the old-fashioned way. It's like every second we spend one penny here. It's like having an even better portable slot. Oh, give me the sweet pills. And I think I can turn that Eternal Heart into some red hearts via Guppy's Paw. Should be able to. All right, there we go. It paid out with Cartridge, which is a trinket. Our existing trinket was Cancer, which is pretty good, but I guess I'm mandated by Rebirth Law. I'll take this speed up here. I'm mandated by Rebirth Law to take the new one. I don't know what it does, and to be honest with you, I couldn't even hazard a guess as to what it does. But, sure. Guppy's Paw doesn't work. So do we take Guppy's Paw with us in the hopes of getting more HP, or do we stick with Crystal Ball? I think we stick with Crystal Ball, even though I kind of effed up. I thought I could turn the Eternal Heart into Spirit Hearts. If I'd known that I couldn't, I wouldn't have picked it up, because we get a damage downgrade as a result of, well, not downgrade, but we won't have Horror of Babylon. I'm hoping to take the, that's a good item, yeah, but I'm hoping to take the Emperor card with us. There we go. And as a result of this, we might be able to get a deal with the devil. Thought that would be the, we should get this. Thought that would be the secret room. Because it's not, I'm just gonna go. No deal with the devil. There we go, the orifice eventually opened up there. I was scared for a minute that it never would. Alright, double damage time. This is where things get a little scary. I will definitely open these for the Guppy chance. Doesn't look like we got it. I was gonna say, is that the end of the room? If so, that's pretty easy. Just like two flies. Two spiders, I should say. We didn't get any Guppy items, but we picked up a spirit heart or two. I'm okay with that. Fistula still as easy as ever, thankfully. This is a mob trap room, not a boss trap room, so that means three bosses. Unfortunately. Our attack fly is doing real work, though. I'm digging it. I hope the music's not too loud, by the way. Let me know. Some of these rooms have, like, you know, loud music. That's just how it goes. I think it's fine. I shout, so it's okay. Why am I standing right next to it? I got lucky, though. Easy room. Easy room, easy life. We'll move along. We don't need to go to every room on the womb. Just the ones we have to go to. Occasionally, is that what Rotten Baby does? Occasionally it spits out a blue fly? Oh, I walked into the poop. Flatworm. I think that changes our shots in some way, but I'm gonna stick with Cartridge, because our shots are not normal tiers, so they're not really as affected by it. Oh, okay. That surprised me. So we got like double pin going on here. Wow, that's one way to do it. Yeah, well, at least now I know what to expect when I see this room next time, but holy crap, that scared me. Empress, we're going to use it. I really thought that would explode in my face. We're going to use the Empress card on this boss, because we're going to use the Emperor card on the next boss. Extra keys. Again, I'm deliberately not exploring every room. Because I expect to take more damage on those rooms than they'll give me in terms of health. Yeah, these are the first time we've encountered these gluttonies in Rebirth. Ugh. They're annoying in vanilla. Let's hope they stay merely annoying. These guys are also really annoying. Rebirth or otherwise. Oh, I haven't been using Crystal Ball. I actually just facepalmed there for a second. That's such a rookie mistake. I have never seen these guys before. Not using Crystal Ball is actually, like, comically dumb. I'm sorry about that. Well, we'll do what we've been doing, and we'll gamble maybe until we get down to 40 cents on this guy. Because I would love to get some extra HP or Spirit Hearts. Or, sure, money. What did I say? 40 cents? 40 cents is fine, but never mind. We got a pill. It's... I can see forever. It opened up those, like, secret room paths there, which is weird. I guess it's just basically, being able to have the map and compass for the floor. So hopefully this boss is relatively easy. Teratoma. Yeah, that's pretty much the definition of relatively easy. If I end up losing this run because I didn't use Crystal Ball, and I end up losing by like a Spirit Heart or two, I'm gonna be real mad. At myself. I'm still getting used to Isaac stuff, so... Or to Rebirth stuff, I should say. That's a speed upgrade. That's really not what we needed. But this is... We're coming, like, right to the end of the game here. Is that, like, a tinted rock? It's got a cross on it. I don't know. Oh, second secret room. Hello. I appreciate that a great deal. That's a really cool effect there, too. We're going back, by the way. Oh, that's a mini-boss in that room. We're going back to get our Emperor card. Do I want to fight the mini-boss? It's just Sloth. Could give me a useful tarot card. We got fire damage over time anyway. That was really easy. We got... Oh, careful. We got Bob's Rotten Head. Oh, and we unlocked the Parasite as a result of picking that up, I guess. Crystal Ball is charged, so actually, we might as well take Bob's Rotten Head with us, because we're going to just fight the boss immediately upon reaching the next floor. And I would be very, very surprised if we end up not beating Mom's Hearts as a result of this one. It would be a nice little penance for that terrible run that I had earlier as well, right at the start of this one. Alrighty. Shouldn't be this hard to beat Mom's Heart, but here we are. Room part one. We might as well check out this room that we spawned right next to. We got the keys for, that's for sure. And maybe there's something incredibly useful here. Bombs? Bombs, yeah. Spirit Heart, that's really useful. Now we'll teleport into the boss room with the Emperor card. Mom's Heart, let's do this. It's not even It Lives yet. Good. I wonder what our tier effect is from $3 bill. Oh, man. This is a weird one. This is a little different. Yeah, this seems like... This is more like the Isaac fight. But I think we're still gonna be good. There's Bob's Rotten Head, we used it. Oh, it's like straight up bullet hell now. But the bullets move at like different speeds! Oh! Little scary. Don't throw, don't throw, you got it. You got it, man. Why do I have invincibility right now? We won. I think we won. There's a deal with the devil. I thought about going into it, but I figured we might as well get the ending. Okay. Enjoy. So I think that cutscene means that we unlocked Eden. Now, Eden is that character that I think, if I look here, you, you get tokens based on wins, and then you can play Eden, and Eden's kind of different every time. So I think definitely next run we'll end up playing as Eden just for fun. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed that run. If you did, as much as I did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal, and of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. Again, this series is going to go on five ever, so you might as well, show your support if you're a fan, and stick around, subscribe if you want to see more in the future, and click the like button if you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon with another episode, maybe later today, maybe tomorrow, I don't know what the release schedule is going to be, but thanks for watching, see you next time!